Now then, I do a very warm welcome to A Bit More Yorkshire Brass. This is show number 129 in our online series. David Hoyle with you for a couple of hours of your brass band favourites. All requests on this show, it's your show, I just present it. That was for Neil in Home Firth. James Curnow's Fanfare and Flourishes was played by the CWS Glasgow Band. Great way to start the show, and we're going to carry on with our first march now. This is for Michelle in Rochdale. Both marches today, in fact, are by Sousa. This one is arranged for brass band by Keith Wilkinson, and Michelle's choice is played by the Brickhouse and Rastrick Band, The Washington Post. Sousa's March. The Washington Post was arranged for brass band by Keith Wilkinson and played by the Brickhouse and Rastrick Band for Michelle in Rochdale. I remember that music when I was a boy, and a near neighbour of ours used to have a set of alternative words involving a wall and a cat. How dare she? I can't read them out on this programme. It's a sackable. I'd have to sack myself. Next up, Alison in Poppleton. This week's overture is for her. She says, I would love to hear William Rimmer's arrangement of Rossini's Tancredi. Is that possible? Not only is it possible, it's going to be played by the oldest brass band in the world, Alison, as well. Here we go, the Stalybridge Old Band and Tancredi. William Rimmer's arrangement of Rossini's overture Tancrede was played for Alison in Poppleton by the Stalybridge Old Band, the oldest brass band in the world, formed in 1809. That overture was first performed in Venice at Teatro La Fenice 4 years later, in 1813. So the band and the overture are very, very similar ages. John in Malton, hello to you. Thank you very much indeed for your message and happy birthday for the coming week. John says, I'm a big fan of the Black Dyke Band and particularly of their principal cornet player, Richard Marshall, who is a lovely lad and a great player. He certainly is one of the nicest people in banding. I say that many, many times. John, your choice is music written by another John, John Hartman, and our first solo this week is Wiedeker.
Thank you. Thank you.
always a joy to listen to the wonderful sound of Richard Marshall. Richard was accompanied there by the Black Dyke Band playing John Hartman's Wiedeker. The first solo of the week was requested by John in Malton. Chapel Allerton is our next stop. We say hello to Kerry. Thank you very much for listening, Kerry, and thanks for getting in touch on the email. yorkshirebrass@gmail.com is the email address if you want to send a request into the show. This music is great. Kerry, I'm so glad you've chosen it. It's by Neil Hannon and played by the Stannington Band. Kerry says, in my time, I spent some time flying up and down the M1 in these vehicles to London when I was a student, and it was the cheapest way to travel, and probably still is. Could I please hear National Express? You certainly can. Here we go. Stannington Band playing Neil Hannon's National Express. Kerry in Chapel Allerton near Leeds used to spend many, many hours as a student popping up and down the M1 on a National Express coach. And fond memories, she says. Yeah, great piece of music for brass band. And thanks, Kerry, for requesting it. What am I talking about this week? I'm going to talk about TV catchphrases, not just comedy ones, but There are certain phrases, aren't there, that are associated with certain programmes. Most of them are comedy, because I like to have a bit of a laugh. You're not allowed to have fun these days, somebody said to me the other day, so tell me about it. It's tough. It is tough, but I'm delighted with your messages, which say that this program does bring you some joy and relaxation. It's my pleasure to do it. And how about Yeah But Nobbert? That was from Little Britain. To be honest, it's a program that I've not really watched that much. But one program I did watch when I was a youngster was Crackerjack. Do you remember when Stu Francis, those of you who are old enough, and Stu Francis used to come up with things like, "Oh, I could crush a grape," or "I could rip a tissue," or "I could jump off a doll's house." There was just some great stuff. And what about this one? This was not a comedy one by any means, but fairly recently, do you remember? Jesus, Mary, Joseph and the Wee Donkey. You must all remember that one. Absolutely. AC-12 and all that. And I'll Have Half. Now, I'm not going to tell you what programme that one was from. It was from a 1970s ITV programme. I'll Have Half. I'll Have Half. See if you can remember. What we got coming up next? Another Flugel solo. We had a few of these, didn't we, last week? This is for Helen in Sheffield. She's a Flugel player, and her band have asked her if she'd like to play this piece of music. "Can you play me a recording to show me how it's done? Because that's how I like to learn," says Helen. Helen, that's the way I learn. If a new piece of music comes out and I've got a recording of it, I will just sit and listen and listen and listen, work out where my part goes in, and take it from there. This music is by Randy Newman, and it's from a film about a pig. Babe, Pig in the City. This is John Doyle with the Black Dyke Band. That'll do. Do you know there's one of the finest chords a brass band can play in there towards the beginning of the piece? If you missed it, listen again. That was John Doyle and the Black Dyke Band playing Randy Newman's That'll Do from Babe Pig in the City. Helen in Sheffield is a flugel player, and I'm sure, Helen, you'll have lots of joy and happiness in learning that piece of music. That'll do, I say that'll do, Fred Elliott. We're talking about catchphrases. And just, I say, I'll have a pork pie, I say, I'll have a pork pie. Ashley, I say Ashley. I used to love Fred Elliott. I thought it was so funny. And Reg Holdsworth, he used to make me laugh on Corrie when I used to watch it. I don't watch it now because it's just not good anymore. But Reg Holdsworth, Mr. Watts, take an early lunch. I just used to love him. Next up, old Woodley and Johnny. Johnny says, I think this is what I'd describe as an all-action piece of music. But it to me, is it could be a silent film. It's busy. It's quick. And it's technically very difficult to play, says Johnny. Could I hear W. Hogarth Lear's Pell Mell, please? Of course you can. The Corrie Band are playing here.
Thank you.
The Corey Band playing Pell Mell by W. Hogarth Lear. W. Hogarth Lear is an anagram of Elgar Howarth. And several pieces, actually, quite a number, where he used that pseudonym. Johnny and Al Woodley again, thanks very much indeed for your request. Time for another solo now. This is for Christine in Ilkley. I'm sat here eating a fat rascal. How dare you? How dare you? I love them. It's worth a day rover, a West Yorkshire day rover, just to go to Ilkley and get a fat rascal and a sausage roll from a certain renowned butcher's. Christine, you've made a lovely choice. And this is an alternative title, if you like, to a piece of music that we perhaps know by a better title. And that better title is Demelza. This is a cornet solo. When we've heard it before as Demelza, it's been a tenor horn or a soprano cornet solo. Gough Richards made this arrangement and it's played on the B-flat cornet. Tabby Clegg is the soloist here with the United Corp Yorkshire Brass Band, made of the moor.
Thank you.
Lovely. Tabby Clegg with the United Co-op Yorkshire Band playing Gough Richards, made of the moor. Demelza was penned by Hugh Nash. I do believe it's the same person. Christine in Ilkley, thank you very much indeed for that request. That was on Facebook. Yorkshire Brass is the name of our Facebook group. Welcome to all our new joiners this week. We've had a number again, lots of you in the group. It's your group again. You talk about everything brass banding. We have a bit of fun now and again. And just in general, problems get solved. Absolutely. I'll tell you about what about solving problems as well. I'm just going to say this. Every week, I probably receive 6 or 7 emails about music we've played on the show, and you as listeners want to know where you can buy that music from. That's absolutely super, and I'm always happy to send you the link as to where you can buy the CD or download the track and pay for it, whatever. You just get in touch with me, I will do the rest. I'm talking about catchphrases today. I was always, and still am really, a big fan of Are You Being Served and all the innuendo that came in there. And Mrs. Slocum, dear Mrs. Slocum and that cat. And when she used to say, I am unanimous in that. And then Mr. Humphreys, menswear, I'm free. Yes, what a great programme. And again, some of the things that are in there now, we wouldn't be allowed to do it today. It was gentle fun. And, well, who remembers Hilda Baker when she used to have, well, Pledger's Pickles, but she used to be the landlady in a pub called the Brown Cow. And when the telephone rang, she used to pick it up and she'd say, hello, this is the Brown Cow speaking. Absolutely brilliant. Hilda Baker, what an absolute superstar. Next up, an absolute blockbuster of a film theme. This is for Sam in Bolton. No reason for the request other than to say thank you for bringing us this program every week. It's my pleasure, Sam, and couldn't do it without producer Jem. And I have to say, I'm recording this week's program with a puppy sat by me, which belongs to producer Jem. His name is Rafa, and he's just 4 months old. He's lovely. It's absolutely lovely. It's just wrapped around my feet at the moment as I'm doing the recording. Sam in Bolton, thank you very much. You want to hear the Grimethorpe Colliery Band version of John Williams' Jurassic Park.
Thank you.
fabulous, isn't it? The main theme from Jurassic Park by John Williams was played by the Grimethorpe Colliery Band for Sam in Bolton. Those of you who have played it, or if you are playing it, my favourite brass band chord in any piece is at letter A when the euphoniums take the melody. Don't care what it's marked, put some air through it. Make it sound warm. Beautiful, absolutely. And talking about beautiful, we're at that time of the week again where we get to the quiet piece, the reflective piece, if you like. And this week we're going to Derby. Rachel has made this choice. This is a piece of music that I've played some lovely chords in this too. The music is by Kenneth Downey, and the Skelmanthorpe Band are playing here. Rachel in Derby's choice, In Perfect Peace. In Perfect Peace by Kenneth Downey was played there by the Skelmanthorpe Band. For Rachel in Derby, Rachel sent an email to yorkshirebrass@gmail.com. You can do the same if you'd like to request one of our quiet, reflective pieces or anything. All I will say is if it is a time-specific request, please give us a few weeks' notice because these shows are planned well in advance for compliance purposes. Back to my list. What have we got on this list of TV quotes? What's occurring? Gavin and Stacey. Oh, there was some really funny stuff in there, weren't there? And other funny stuff were Only Fools and Horses. I mean, so many things in there. All right, Dave. Trig. All right, Dave. Called Rodney Dave every time, didn't he? And Delbo. You plonker. Great programme. Tommy Cooper. All about Tommy Cooper when he used to go, just like that. Just like that. I remember him doing a sketch once, and it was in a travel agency, which... obviously, for those of you who know, my proper job is as a travel agent. And there was a big sign behind him and it said, Mallorca, beautiful island. And in his voice, he was telling this story. And I want to go there. What just a funny man. But you had to watch him for it to be funny. Catchphrase. Who watched the TV programme Catchphrase with that lovely Irish accent from Roy Walker? Say what you see. And Different Strokes. I remember watching Different Strokes as a boy. And Gary Coleman as Arnold was hilarious. What are you talking about, Willis? And he used to turn his head to the side and his eyes were wide open. What are you talking about, Willis? What are we talking about next? Kevin in Bradley, near Huddersfield, taking us to halfway this week with a piece of music which moves apace. This is an arrangement by good friend of the show, Derek Broadbent, and the music of Aram Khachaturian. The St. Denis Band play the Sabre Dance. Derek Broadbent's arrangement of the Sabre Dance by Adam Cacciaturian was played for Kevin in Bradley by the St Denis Band. The second part of this week's programme takes us on a little ride. Karen in Upper Mill has been in touch to say that her band have recently got this piece of music out on the stand. We're really, really enjoying it. Struggling with some parts of it, and if there is a good version, then I'd like to hear it, says Karen. Well, this is a good version, all right. It's by the Fairy Band, the music of Ralph Blaine. 1944, this song was written. It's called The Trolley Song. Clang, clang, clang went the trolley. The Trolley Song. Ralph Blaine's music was played by the Fairy Band for Karen in Upper Mill. Now then, we've got a birthday. We've got a birthday. Two emails in front of me here. The first one asked me if I can play The March of the Smurfs. Well, unfortunately, Philip, I can't. Because I haven't got a recording of it. But if not, says Philip, I'd like to hear this particular march. Well, it's coming up in a minute. Your son's also been in touch to tell me that it's your 67th birthday. How dare he? How dare he tell people that you're 67? Anyway, he loves playing the second baritone and loves playing our version of this particular piece of music. Second baritone with the Egremont Town Band. Happy birthday, young man. More Sousa, this time arranged by Aud Hume. The Williams Ferry Band are with us again, playing the Liberty Bell.
Thank you.
The Williams Fairy Band wishing Philip Humphreys a very happy 67th birthday. Aud Hume's arrangement of Sousa's March, The Liberty Bell. Thanks to Philip's son Stuart for getting in touch as well. And good wishes to all of you at the Egremont Town Band. Next up is another solo. David is in Long Marston in Warwickshire and a euphonium player. I'm looking for a slow euphonium solo to play in my band, Oily. And I wonder if you might make any suggestion. I absolutely will. And I've tried to go for something that, in my opinion, isn't played as often as it should be. This is a lovely piece of music by Gough Richards. The soloist on this recording is Ian Plant, and the Hebden Bridge Band are playing. The piece is called Midnight Euphonium.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's lovely that, isn't it? Midnight Euphonium by Gough Richards. The soloist was Ian Plant, their band were the Hebden Bridge Band. And that was for David in Longmaston in Warwickshire, who is looking for a slow euphonium solo to play. I hope that one fits the bill. Upping the tempo a bit now as we go to Paula in West Houghton. Enjoying playing this with my band, says Paula, at the minute. And I know that you've got a recording because you played it a few months ago. And I think, says Paula, if I'm right, you were playing on the recording. Bang on. Back of the net, as Alan Partridge said in his TV programme. How about that, eh? TV catchphrases we're talking about today. And yes, back of the net. Paula in West Houghton, this is for you. The Lindley Band, conducted by Rob Westercott, on this recording of Dance to the Daddy by Daryl Barry.
Thank you.
Daryl Barry's Dance to the Daddy, played there for Paula in West Houghton by the Lindley Band. I was playing on that recording. I love that piece of music as well, Paula. I think it's absolutely smashing. Now, tempo down again. And another request here for Kathleen Melling. She now lives in Cleethorpes. Well, I should say the request is from Kathleen for her brother Barry Hurst. Barry, it lives in Scarborough, but originally lived in Haydedge. And Kathleen says anything played by the Haydedge band would be appropriate. Well, this is a lovely piece of music, absolutely wonderful, arranged by Simon Wood, and Simon was conducting the band on this particular recording. The Haydedge band play What a Difference a Day Makes.
Thank you.
The Haight Edge Band, What a Difference a Day Makes. Playing that for Barry Hurst, formerly of Haight Edge, now living in Scarborough, and sent with good wishes from his sister Kathleen Mellin, who now lives in Cleethorpes. Thanks all for listening. Back to this list of TV sayings. What haven't I done yet? Oh, how about Ali G? Booyakasha! He was so funny, wasn't he? Booyakasha, booyakasha. Dick Emery. Who used to watch Dick Emery on a Saturday night when he used to dress up as a woman, and he used to say, "Oh, you are awful, but I like you," and then he used to slap him with an handbag. Absolutely brilliant. Victor Meldrew, we've got to do Victor, haven't we? "I don't believe it. In the name of sanity." I use that a lot, "in the name of sanity." I use that honestly in everyday life. I used to love On the Buses as well. "Get that bus out, Butler." They used to love that programme. It's just harmless fun, and we don't have enough of it now, do we? Next up, this is a TV theme, actually, strangely enough, and Steve in Silkstone has been in touch to request this one. "I know that this was used in America for the NBC Today programme. I've watched it several times when I've been in America. But Steve says it was used in a UK programme." Now, Steve, I think this was used in more than one programme. I know it was definitely used in a programme called The Secret Life of Machines on Channel 4. But there is something in the back of my mind that says it was a tea time programme that children used to watch in the 70s. I've got Out of Town with Jack Hargreaves in mind, but I've looked it up and it doesn't kind of match. But somehow, I don't know whether that programme had more than one theme tune. You'll let me know anyway, won't you? I know you will. If there's people out there who have watched a TV programme 50 years ago, you've got great memories. The Hepworth Band are playing, and the choice of Steve in Silkstone is the music of Dave Brubeck. It's called Take Five. Thank you. Take 5 by Dave Brubeck, the Hepworth Band were playing there for Steve, who was in Silkstone. We know that it was used on the NBC Today programme in America and also on a Channel 4 programme called The Secret Life of Machines. If you know it was used on anything else, you know what to do. YorkshireBrass@gmail.com, pop it into the Facebook group, which is Yorkshire Brass, our private members group. Sad news recently, says Alan in Lightcliffe. Yes, indeed, the death of Stephen Corbett. Great servant to brass bands. And Alan says, I'd like to pay tribute to Stephen and share a wonderful piece of music with the listeners, if that's okay. It's absolutely grand, no problem whatsoever. The Brighouse and Rustic Band made this LP after the success of the Floral Dance, and this particular track was on it. It features the great Brian Evans on soprano cornet, and Stephen Corbett made this arrangement for him of Neil Sedaka's Solitaire.
Thank you.
Brian Evans and the Brighouse and Rastrick Band playing Solitaire by Neil Sedaka, arranged by Stephen Corbett. Stephen sadly passed away very recently, and Alan in Lightcliffe wanted us to pay tribute with that piece of music. Test piece time now, and a lovely piece this week. This has been chosen by Peter and Jenny, who are in Greenfield. It's in three movements, and as test pieces go, this is right up there for me. One of the very best. The first movement is called Resilience, the second movement is Romance, and the third movement is Relaxation. Gilbert Vinter's Salute to Youth is played by the Williams Fairy Band.
We'll be right back.
This week's test piece, Gilbert Vinter's Salute to Youth, was played by the Williams Fairy Band at the request of Peter and Jenny in Greenfield. I would love to hear that test piece chosen as an area or a finals piece in the near future. Nudge, nudge, please. Back to my list. Now then, Leonard Rossiter, what an absolute star. And he had, a couple of catchphrases, you could say. I really liked him in The Fall and Rise of Reginald Perrin. And he used to go into his office every morning. He used to throw either his bowler hat or his umbrella at a coat stand, and he used to miss. And he used to say, "Morning, Joan, 11 minutes late." It was always 11 minutes late. "Morning, Joan, 11 minutes late. Cow on the line at Clapham Junction." And the excuse was different every single episode, until the one when he retired. The train was on time. He threw both the hat and the umbrella, and both of them landed on the hat stand. But I think he's probably best remembered for playing Rigsby in Rising Damp. My God, Miss Jones. Brilliant actor. Absolutely brilliant actor. And another TV series, a comedy, which I liked very much, was Dad's Army. Don't panic. And then, you stupid boy. But the best line of them all had to be, hadn't it, from Arthur Lowe, when the Germans were being inquisitive. What's your name? Don't tell him, Pike. And then how about Frank Spencer? Well, Betty, I'm in a little bit of trouble. And then he used to say, the cat's done a whoopsie. Oh dear. Hymn tune time. Anne in Burnley. Could you please play me this hymn tune, which is written about a place near me? Well, it's named after a place near you, and it's named after the valley that I live in. But in truth, it's about neither. It was written in New Zealand, and it was written for a Salvation Army Corps in America. So it's got nothing to do with Cone in Lancashire. It's got nothing to do with the Cone Valley. But it's worth a listen, because it's brilliant. This is a smashing arrangement of Thomas Rives' hymn tune Cone, and it's played for Anne in Burnley by the Grimthorpe Colliery Band. Lovely, isn't it? Some really lovely chords, a lovely melody anyway, that hymn tune. Cone by Thomas Rive. The Grimthorpe Colliery Band were playing for Anne in Burnley. Two more pieces to go this week. Let me just cross another couple of things off this list of television catchphrases. How about hello, hello? Listen very carefully. Have I said this only once? But it was the policeman, wasn't it? Officer Crabtree. Every episode he used to, the door in Cafe René used to open, the bell would ring, and then all of a sudden, good morning. It was fantastic. Absolutely blooming brilliant. I absolutely loved it. Right, the penultimate piece today is for Nick in Guiseley. Now, when I was on the radio, I used to say, yeah, I will be after I've played this piece of music, but I record this music from home now, so I don't have to do this anymore. But this is one of the finest television theme tunes ever for me. It's played by the Roberts Bakery Band, and the music is by Dennis King. Nick in Guiseley has requested the theme music to Black Beauty, Galloping Home. Galloping Home, the theme from Black Beauty, written by Dennis King and played there by the Roberts Bakery Band for Nick in Guiseley. Right, the final bit on this list of sayings. I have to go with Basil Fawlty. He's just my hero. 12 episodes, there didn't need to be any more because it would have got silly. But things like, "Evening, Major." "Hello, Fawlty Towers." "Yes, yes. We're not full." "Of course we're not full, you fool." And then he used the catchphrase all the time. "Thank you. Thank you so much." And he used to call Sybil, his wife Sybil, all sorts of names. "My little piranha fish. My little nest of vipers." And he'd come up with all sorts of things, just rude. And it was modelled on a hotel that he'd stayed in when he was a younger man. And he made a really, really big success out of it. My favourite episode, for the record. The Germans was my second favourite. The ingrowing toenail and the moose. And the doctor said to him, "It's an ingrowing toenail." "Oh, you know, do you? Well, that'll help. Ingrowing toenail, right foot. You'll find it on the end of the leg." That's my second favourite. But Communication Problems, with the brilliant Joan Sanderson playing Mrs. Richards, the lady who was deaf. The comedy between the two of them in that programme was absolutely legendary. Thank you. Thank you so much. We finished today with a great finale. This is for Paul and Jill in York, and this is one of my favourite recordings too. Paul and Jill say, "Was it recorded in a town hall?" I don't know, but I do know somebody who played on the CD, so I'll find out for you. But a lot of these, to be honest, a lot of times the band does their bit, and then the additions, such as an organ in this case, are dubbed onto the top of the band recording. Tricks of the trade and all that. Thanks for listening again. This was show number 129 with me, David Hoyle, and a bit your Yorkshire Brass. 130 coming up next week with more of your requests. Keep them coming, yorkshirebrass@gmail.com or in the Facebook group, Yorkshire Brass. The Yorkshire Imperial Band leave us today with a request for Paul and Jill in York. The music of Trevor Jones. Bye from me, David Hoyle, and Puppy Raffa. Hasn't he been good? We leave you with The Gale from The Last of the Mohicans. Thank you.